How was the experience of being part of Maza?
Maza aa gaya. I've always liked Mr. Parag's song. He is a great singer.
Right now you're this huge star down south.
Honestly, I call myself an entertainer. So either this way or that way, I have to entertain. You know, honestly, my 50th film. It has it's my first female-centric film, and you know, getting Maha. To the point where Maha.
What has been the contribution of your mother in your career?
Everything.
And
everything. I am what I am is because of my mom. Hi, my name is Hansika Motwani, and you're watching Bollywood Hangama.
Hansika Motwani, welcome on Bollywood Hangama.
Thank you for having me.
I believe you've just been part of your 50th film now.
Yes, I've just completed my 50th film.
Which is amazing. And you're still so young.
Thank you.
I think it's a conscious decision maybe on your part to get into this Hindi music video space as well. Maza is coming out. Bree Prak. Very strong vocals.
Very strong. And very strong lyrics.
Very strong lyrics as well. Yeah. And I think melancholic songs, they always work. Sad songs, people... A lot of heartbroken people around, so people like to relate to it.
True that.
All right, so how was the experience of being part of Maza for you?
Maza aa gaya. Honestly, I was not expecting, that I will do a music video and it will be this kind of a music video. But I enjoyed doing this. And when we shot it and... Above all, the song is such a nice song. If you hear it, the music, and it just touches your heart. So I really enjoyed being part of this.
The way the presentation, it's looking like any movie song. The scale and especially in the emotional angle, you're able to showcase a range of emotions as well. Was that the reason for you to go ahead and do this music video?
I'll be honest, I've always liked Mr. Parag's song. He is a great singer. I've heard a lot about Arvind Khera sir, who's our director, before I worked with him. And you know how he makes, like, hum picture jab dikhate hain, hamare paas 2-2.5 ghante hote hain. But ek gaane mein story dikhana, we have only 4 minutes. And I've heard about his storytelling. And when I heard the song, I just wanted to be a part of it. And I knew that I will get... to be a part of a great song also where I can show my emotions and emote.
I've done interviews with many artists, many actors and actresses as well. One thing that we have come to realize, and even in terms of the research on what sort of music works, so it has come to notice that sad songs really work very well, as we were just discussing that a lot of hearts have been broken.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe an element of... catharsis is there when you watch or listen to a sad song. Do you agree with that?
I do, actually. I think sad songs grow on you. Like, there's no saturation point with a sad song. It just grows on you. And but with this song, to be very honest, it doesn't need to grow on you. Like, bar bar sunne ki zarurat nahi hai. Pehli dafa sunoge na aapko acha lagega. This definitely has a very long term.
As an actor, do you also dip into your own inner resources, you know, in terms of, I think everyone has various experiences, relationships, and some relationships don't work out, and that pain is there, and obviously one moves on. But when as an artist, you're required to showcase a certain set of emotions. Do you dip inside your own heart and bring out certain emotions?
Honestly, no. I don't say that ki massive emotions ke liye, you know, when I'm sad, I have to like think something bad. When I'm happy, I have to think something happy. I just go with the flow. Honestly, but when you hear the song also, it takes you in a zone. So I don't think I have to like, you know, punch on my heart and say like, kya bura hua tha, wo sochta rahe emote karte hai. It's not that for me. It's very easy for me to emote if I hear the song, if I understand the song or the lyrics or the dialogues or anything of that sort.
Did you speak to Bree Prak?
I actually, once I spoke to him on set, on the call, and just saying, congratulations for one more hit, because I'm sure the song will do extremely well. And honestly, the song is really nice. It's genuinely nice. I wouldn't say it because I'm promoting it or it's my song or something like that. It's a nice song. It's genuinely a nice song.
Right. And I believe you're also doing a few more Punjabi songs, from what I understand.
Yes, I am. But I actually had in last week I had another release, and this week another release. So I think I have best of both, right?
Do you also think from this perspective that is it a conscious decision that it also gives you a more pan-India sort of audience? Because right now you're this huge star down south, but this is something that is noticed everywhere.
Honestly, I call myself an entertainer. So either this way or that way, I have to entertain. It was not a conscious decision, to be very honest. It's just a coincidence that both the songs have come. ID, this was supposed to be my first release. I had just both the songs back to back. I shot and it just happened. It just happened. It's just, I don't know how, but it just happened. They both approached me. And a lot of songs now keep, you know, coming. And, you know, we have songs and this and that because we were shooting for like 2-3 days and stuff like that. So it's just a coincidence, to be honest.
And how's the entire experience of shooting during these COVID times?
Tough, yeah. I miss the crowd on set. I miss the banter on set. That everything is so conscious. Everyone's in a mask and I'm like, aapko pehle dekha hai kahin? Acha, aapko. And I'm just like, okay. And I keep saying, Hansika, this is a director, this is a cameraman, you know, don't goof up. But COVID time is hard, yeah. Come on, let's just be honest. You know, getting your tests done, being on set, your crew has to be small. And I'm a person who loves to be around people. So I miss that crowd, to be honest.
You've worked in Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, Kannada.
Ji.
All the languages and you had, I think, wonderful success as well. How do you sum up this journey down south?
I think I'm very fortunate. I'm very, very lucky. At my age, you know, usually girls start up, you know, they're still figuring what they want to do, and I'm well settled. I've done 50 films. I have yet a lot to achieve, but I'm very contented and I'm very happy with my journey.
Which has been the most satisfying experience so far as an actor?
You know, honestly, my 50th film, it has, it's my first female centric film, and, you know, getting Maha. To the point where, yeah, Maha, my first film, which is actually a female-centric film, and you know, it's a very big feeling, you know, when you have like a film is sold on your name as an actor. It takes a lot. So my 50th film is that there's a lot of expectations, and just completing, I'm not even 30 and I've completed my 50th film, is just like a good high.
No, definitely it is. Yeah. Okay. Now I'm sure that this question must be asked to you quite a few times. Maybe you are tired of it as well, but you started off in Hindi films.
Right.
When do we see you in Hindi films? There are more options today when it comes to web as well, web space, web shows. Does that excite you?
I'm already doing a web series, but that's in Telugu. It's on Amazon. That's yet to come out. I'm open to entertain anywhere, to be honest, Faridut, you know, wherever I get a chance. I'm an entertainer. For me, language is not a barrier. If something great comes up in Hindi, I'm definitely open to it.
I spoke to Ashish Vidyarthi ji a few days back.
Ji, of course.
He had done a lot of Hindi films and he moved down south.
Yes.
He's of the opinion, and quite a few other people there of the opinion, that it is far more organized down south. The artists, they're respected a lot. Things are more punctual and more systematic. Is that the case with you as well?
See, I wouldn't want to say that, you know, here the cinema are not punctual or not, you know, well on time or whatever that sort. But yeah, Tamil industry is a little more disciplined. You know what I mean? But it really depends how the production handles it, what time the director wants to give a break, what are the requirements. So I would say it's easy. It's just that things have to be proper from the production side, to be honest. I cannot just say, because sometimes, you know, like in Tamil, I shoot 9 to 6. But in Malayalam, it's like you have to shoot 9 to 9. So it's different everywhere. It's just different people, different time, different set.
What has been the contribution of your mother in your career?
Everything.
And
everything. I am what I am is because of my mom. I am a celebrity somewhere, and I'm also a normal, you know, kid that my mom has raised me. So I just know how to act. That's all. The rest, everything, my mother takes care. I am I'm a very, I'm not getting the right word. Like, I'm a very protective kid. So yeah, I mean, everything my mom handles, and I am what I am is because of my mom.
I've met her. Yes. And she is very protective.
Hi, my name is Hansika Motwani, and you're watching Bollywood Hangama.